In the past two decades, Islam has grown quite rapidly in the United States of America. Many of the country's states where Islam was not known until the beginning of this century are now home to thousands of Muslims. One such example is that of the largest state of the USA, Alaska. In this video, we will be getting you up to speed with everything you need to know about the Muslim community in Alaska. So let's begin. The first people probably came to what is now Alaska about 13,000 years ago. They either walked from what is now Russia, which was connected to Alaska by a patch of land up to 600 miles wide called the Bering Land Bridge, or they sailed. Russians settled in Alaska in 1784, and in 1867 the United States purchased the land for 2 cents an acre. Many thought the harsh habitat was a bad buy until gold was struck in 1872. Alaska became the 49th US state in 1959. Alright, so in the early 2000s, there were only a few hundred Muslims living in Alaska. However, with the influx of refugees from the Middle East, Africa, the Balkans, and Southeast Asia, the population of Muslims in Alaska grew to around 3,000. These refugees chose to migrate to Alaska mainly because of the state's high economic growth due to oil revenues, conservative values, as well as because it is known to welcome refugees from conflict areas. Alaska deserves its reputation for being cold. Much of the state is covered in a layer of permafrost, permanently frozen soil, and it's home to the largest glacier in North America. Moving on, since there was not a single mosque in Alaska at that time, the Muslim community chose a strip mall in the middle of Anchorage, the largest city of the state, where they would hold congregational prayers. Soon they realized that the space offered by the mall was too small to accommodate thousands of Muslims. That's when the idea of building the first mosque of Alaska started to float. So in 2008, the leaders of the Muslim community of Alaska commenced work to turn this dream into a reality. Unfortunately, at that time, Alaska's Muslim community was composed largely of refugees who had little money. So every few months, the leaders of the community had to fly to other states of the USA looking for donations. Finally, in 2010, the work on the mosque began. After 4 years of construction in 2014, the first mosque of Alaska, the Islamic Community Center of Anchorage, Alaska, ICCAA, came to life. A few years later, an Islamic school named Fahid al-Aida was also inaugurated. To date, the ICCAA and the Fahid al-Aida school continue to serve the Muslim community of Alaska, which according to the last census has grown to nearly 5,000. The majority of these Muslims reside in Anchorage, where both the ICCAA and Fahid al-Aida school are located. Although the Muslim community of Alaska is comprised of people from diverse backgrounds and cultures, there is hardly any friction between the opposing groups. It's because they understand that Islam comes before any culture or ethnicity. One of the best examples that shows the solidarity of Alaskan Muslims is the time of Ramadan. Now, traditionally Muslims start their fast at dawn and break at sunset when the Maghrib Adhan is called. However, when a country is situated above the Arctic Circle like Alaska is, there really is no sunset during summers or sunrises during winters. So what's their routine, you may ask? Well, Siddiqul Muhammad, a Muslim resident in Alaska, describes their Ramadan routine saying, "The sun rises at about 4 o'clock in the morning and sets around midnight. As such, we fast from 4 a.m. to 12 a.m. That's around 20 hours of fast. Though it sounds harsh, Siddiqul's mother, Hajia Serena, finds fasting in Alaska easier than fasting in West Africa, their home country. She says, "The weather here is cool, so I can fast without even eating anything. I don't feel hungry at all, but in Ghana, due to the heat, you'd be eager to break the fast. Since I have been fasting here, I have never worried about how long it is." Though Hajia Serena's patience is commendable, some Muslims in Alaska prefer breaking their fasts based on Makkah's time. Athar Chaudhry, a prominent Muslim at the Islamic Center, says, "In summers, days could be as long as 21 hours, and in December, the days could be only as long as 3 hours. So we have been told by scholars from the Islamic Center of Northern Norway to follow a standard time zone, and what we do is we stick to the time frame of Makkah, which is the holiest place in Islam. We fast from 4 a.m. until around 7 p.m. Athar Chaudhry's wife, Zakia, finds Ramadan in Alaska to be similar to their routine in Bangladesh. She says, "We eat suhoor, we have iftar, and sometimes we also spend time with the community. The only thing we miss here from back home is there were a lot of Muslims around the neighborhood." Islam in Alaska is defined by heartwarming gestures of the Muslim community celebrating their religion in peace, their diligence in praying the Farz Salah even during the harsh winters and doing their rightful duties as a Muslim without any complaints. Hasib Ali, a Sudani Muslim who moved to Alaska, says, "We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our intentions of fasting on Alaska's time and help us honor Islam the right way. May Allah shower the Muslim community of Alaska with prosperity and continue to add more brothers and sisters to its fold. Ameen."